Everybody say hi to my bear. His name is Clarence, and he will be joining us for today's video. Popping, y'all, it's your girl Lianna Mazing, and I'm back with another video. I know I kind of fell off a little bit these past couple weeks, and I apologize for that. You know, I've just been trying to get my life together, and adulting is definitely not what I thought it was gonna be in 2020, which is glad, which is why I'm glad it's over. Kicking off the new year, one of my resolutions is to be posting more consistently. So you are definitely going to be seeing a lot more of me. So make sure you subscribe, like, comment what type of content you want to see. Comment the content. You can't say that 10 times fast. And all that good stuff. I figure, you know, it's the new year. You want to start it off right. So I just want to start it off by clearing the air, letting you guys know a little bit about me, what I stand for, who I am, all that good stuff. So a couple weeks ago, I had you guys ask me questions that you guys wanted to know the answers to, and as promised, I'll be answering them in this video. I did get a lot of questions, so I'm gonna try to limit it to 21, hence 21 questions. Gang. Just so you know, I wrote all my questions down on this here notepad, so if I'm looking down, that's what I'm reading questions. So without further ado, this week's video, 21 questions with Lianna Mazing. Okay, let's get it. Question one, how are you? Thank you for asking. I'm actually doing pretty good. You know, like, it's a new year. I got my room clean, my house clean, my life pretty clean, you know? Got some good habits going into 2021, and I'm pretty excited for that. So I'm actually doing pretty good, all things considered. Biggest pet peeves. Oh my God. I hate slowness. I hate people who walk slow, talk slow, drive slow, move slow. Like, we don't got all the time in the world. If you knew me in high school, I used to stiff arm motherfuckers in the hallway. Move. If you ever been in the car with me, you know, I will go around somebody so quick. Move. Maybe I'm a little impatient. I'll take that. I'll be impatient. I hate slow people. Question three. If you could live anywhere, where would you choose? Somewhere where it's nice all year, like the Bahamas or like down south, or shit, I would move to Africa. Like somewhere where it's really nice all year round, and where, you know, it's not all this hustle and bustle of the city life, and just, you know, somewhere chill, somewhere nice and serene. Number four, favorite three movies of all time. Okay, this is a hard one because there are like so many movies that I like, but if I had to do like top three, this isn't in order, but I would say Hunger Games, that whole trilogy, I'm gonna count that as one because you just gotta watch it from beginning to end. It's a whole story, you know? I would also say like the Matrix trilogy, because that was my shit. I could watch that over and over again and still question life every single time. And then number three, I'd have to say For Colored Girls. That last one definitely needs a trigger warning. There's like a lot of violence and a lot of like really hard topics that are covered and portrayed in that movie, but it is so powerful, especially for like a woman of color like myself. So that's one of my favorites too. Number five, what is the secret about yourself that most people don't know? Well, if I told you, then it wouldn't be a secret. Just kidding. Honestly, the main secret is I am not confident, like, at all. I'm, like, hella insecure. And a lot of people, like, they're like, oh, you seem so confident. You seem like you have it all together. Honey, fake it till you make it. That's what I'm doing. And I ain't really made it yet. I still be overthinking everything, even these videos. Like, that's why, part of why I haven't posted in so long. Because I will make a piece of content and literally watch it 30,000 times. And hear every single mistake, every single cringe, every single awkwardness. Just be like, nah. What's your favorite food? Watermelon! Not to be a stereotype, but I could really eat that all day, every day. for the rest of my life and never get tired of it. You hungry? You thirsty? At the same time, eat some watermelon. It's like I could really live off that. Like, I don't know who thought of that, but somebody needs to give them an award. If you didn't do music or dance, what would you be doing in life? If I wasn't doing music or dance, I would definitely be teaching math specifically. That's something that has also been a passion of mine. I really love math. Like, ever since I was like in fourth grade doing this early algebra math class, and I ended up working my way up from a student to, you know, a TA to a paid TA to a teacher with my own class pretty soon. And I love teaching. I love, you know, helping give kids that same spark that I felt when I was young for math, like really understanding it for the first time. And, you know, feeling like there was a space for me as like a little black kid in the math world. That's definitely something that I would be pursuing if I wasn't doing music. If you could collab with any deceased artist, who would it be? Nipsey Hussle, hands down, just because he's so dope as an artist, but not just as an artist, but like the things that he does for his community or did for his community, just the things that he did for the music industry. Like, I know I can learn so much from him, and he's somebody that I still do learn from, you know, looking at his old interviews, his old videos, listening to his songs. He has like so many powerful messages, and I would just love to sit down and have a conversation with him and, you know, hop on a track with him. That would be amazing. Who is my biggest musical inspiration and why? I gotta think about that one for a sec. I would say Lauryn Hill, just because she is an amazing vocalist, an amazing singer, and she got bars. Like, she could really spit. And, you know, that's kind of like me. Like, I don't really see too many, like, modern musicians who are really, really dope at doing both. And that's part of why I do both, because I want to be one of those, you know, people who could really just do it all. And she's one of those people to me. And that inspires me, because it's like I see myself in her. What is your biggest goal in life? My biggest goal in life? Shit, I want to change the world. That's just facts. I want to change the world for the better. I want to make this world a better place, and I want to go down in history books for making the world a better place. Not just for people who look like me, but for everybody in it. Whether I do that through music, teaching, politics, I don't know. I don't care. As long as this world is a better place when I leave it than it was when I came into it, that goal will be achieved. Is there a genre of music that I don't like? You know, I'm not even gonna cap. I have listened to like every genre of music, and I can't necessarily say that there are that I don't like any genres, but I can definitely say that there are certain genres that I just don't listen to as much. I feel like there's a time and a place and a mood for every genre, and I'm not always in those moods, but probably the genre that I listen to the least is like, I don't really listen to country music like that anymore. Like, I grew up on it because my dad loved it a lot, and it definitely still does remind me of my childhood, but I can't remember the last time I was just like, I'm gonna just go play a country song. Actually, I do remember. It was Old Town Road. What instruments do you know how to play? I'm so glad you asked. As y'all have probably seen in my Instagram videos, if you follow me on Instagram, I play piano. If you listen to my past YouTube videos, you know I play ukulele. I know like 2.5 songs on guitar, and not even like the strummy kind of songs, but just like the little picky, you know. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. So I don't really claim that, but yeah, those are like my two main, piano and ukulele. How would you describe your style? My music style, I definitely say like I'm kind of like an R&B rap artist. A lot of my like singing songs are more on the R&B side, a little bit of poppy here and there, but not really. And yeah, you know I rap. So in terms of dancing, I would say my go-to dance style is like somewhere between contemporary and hip hop. That's the sweet spot for me. If you could collaborate with any artist, who would? I would honestly love to collaborate with her. Like, her music is so dope to me. Like, her whole vibe, her lyrics, her tone, her, like, everything. I know I could learn so much from her, and I know, like, our voices would just blend, and it would just, oh yes. What song do you remember singing most as a child? If you know me, you already know. When you left, I lost a part of me. It's still so hard to believe. Come back, baby, please, 'cause we belong together. That was my shiznit. We Belong Together by Mariah Carey. My mom said I used to sing that song like my heart had been torn out of my chest and stomped and smashed on the ground. Like, I couldn't have been more than 4 or 5 or 6. Like, imagine the little ass kid singing like a heartbreak song. Like every talent show, every dinner time, anytime anybody asked me to sing anything, it was always that song. And I don't know why, because I had never even experienced heartbreak in my life, but that was my shit. How long have I been dancing? I started dancing when I was in third grade. There was this program called Dance Chance where they went and like auditioned all the kids in the Seattle Public Schools, and it was like they picked the best for this ballet program, and they would like take us, we'd catch this bus like halfway in the middle of the day, and we got to go twice a week all the way up to Pacific Northwest Ballet School downtown Seattle, and we just got to take a ballet class for like a couple hours, and it was so dope. And that was really when I fell in love with dance. I did ballet 3rd and 4th grade, and then they told me like because of the shape of my feet or whatever, like the pointe shoes would have permanently damaged them, so I had to stop ballet. And then that's when I kind of branched out into, you know, experimenting with other styles, you know, hip hop, contemporary. I tried tap for like 2 seconds, but the teacher was kind of mean. But yeah, I've been really dancing ever since, so definitely over half my life, at least 10 years. How old am I? I am about to be 19 this month. Okay, January 23rd, mark your calendars, because that is a Friday. I will definitely be posting a little birthday video for y'all, so stay tuned. But I'm currently 18. How did you and your boyfriend meet? It was actually kind of funny how we met. There was this girl who I did a show with last March. It's called More Music at the More. And she had tagged me in the comments of a post that he had made, and he was looking for, you know, female singers and rappers to collaborate on an album that he was working on. And she tagged me, I messaged him, and then we just started talking. I went to his studio like the next day, and it was like so dope. It was like way bigger and better than I imagined. And just talking to him, I realized like, dang, this dude really knows his stuff. He's really passionate about music. He's really smart and talented and just on it. And that's definitely somebody that I want to have in my life. What do you stand for / represent? I definitely think I stand for the underdogs. You know, like the people that have been overlooked or bullied or hurt or told that they weren't enough or told that nobody cares about them or that they weren't gonna amount to anything. That's who I stand for. And I stand for them because that was me. You know, like growing up, I was bullied a lot. I was told all of that. I was told I was never gonna be a singer. I was never gonna be really anything. And I know how much that hurt me, and I know how much I wished, you know, I had somebody to look up to tell me that, you know, that's a common experience and that you don't have to listen to those people. So I decided at some point, you know, if I don't have nobody to look up to, then shit, I'm gonna be the person for other people to look up to. And that's what I wanna do. That's what I am doing. How does your family feel about your music? My family has really been like my biggest supporters in my whole career, even though it hasn't really started yet. My mama was at all my performances, all my shows, screaming the loudest out of everybody. My sisters, oh my goodness, my sisters used to scream their heads off, and I could always hear them, "That's my sister!" Like, you could tell that they've always been really supportive and really proud of me and my journey, and I'm forever grateful for that. Where do you see yourself as an artist in 5 years? Honestly, in 5 years, by the time I'm, what, 23, 24? I'm gonna be popping. Everybody's gonna know my name. And I don't just mean everybody in Seattle or Atlanta or wherever I'm at, whenever that time is. I mean, everybody gonna know my name. Just like everybody know Beyonce's name. Yeah, I'm headed there. Just give me 5 years. I'ma check back in 5 years, matter of fact. And y'all gonna know I'm finna have like 2 million subscribers, finna have like 10 million Instagram followers. I'm gonna be up there. I'm speaking that into existence now. That's what it's gonna be. And that's it. That's all the questions that you guys had for me. And I just want to thank everybody who contributed a question or, you know, contributed to this video in any way, shape, or form. Because I love, you know, getting feedback from you guys. I love answering your questions. And we should do this again sometime. Thank you for watching if you made it to this point. I know this video is kind of long, but you made it to the end. Thank you. Don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, hit them post notifications, the little ding ding ding, so that you can get notifications whenever I post. Make sure you follow me on all my other social medias, which are always linked in the description. Also, if you haven't already, make sure you go check out my last YouTube video. It was so dope. It was a cover of Feeling Good by Nina Simone, the version by Carly Rae, Son, and Claire. I performed at the Seattle Sound Music Awards, and it was on Zoom, but I recorded the performance, so make sure you go check that out if you haven't already. All right, guys, I'll see you guys next week.